Hey everybody, this is Youth First Wi-Fi Studios. Thank you for joining me on this amazing adventure of FPV. And today we will be setting up the Emax Hawk 5. That's right, I said it, Emax Hawk 5 and the Taranis X-Lite. Yes, that's right, you heard correctly, Taranis X-Lite. Hawk 5, Taranis X-Lite. Yeah, so, wow, it's quite an adventure for sure. I don't know why I have all these batteries over here. Check out my other videos, I did an unboxing for both of these. It was pretty fun. So yeah, I'm gonna put this case to the side. We're not really gonna do anything from here. And we're not really gonna do anything with this yet. Let's just start by taking off the top of the Hawk 5. Oh, also I'm not gonna be using the pagoda antennas. So I could put these in here as well. And I only need 4 props. We're gonna need some wire cutters. We're not really gonna need the X-Acto knife. You're gonna need a hex tool, and you're gonna need something non-conductive to press the buttons on the boards with. And you're gonna need some electrical tape or heat shrink. And you're gonna need a prop tool. That pretty much sums it up. Let's just start with opening up the top, as I said. Opening up the top. These screws were super tight. I already opened it up, but these screws were super tight, which is great, which is a good sign. As you can see here, they've kind of zip-tied the antennas initially inside the quad with on the rear poles here, on the rear standoff thingies there. Now, before we do anything, let us plug in the quad and make sure it works. Alright, so right now it's on channel 1F. I want to switch that to R1. The receiver. We want to bind the receiver. So to do this, there is a bind button right beside this antenna. So what you have to do... that's conductive. What you have to do is you actually have to press this button down while turning the drone on to put this in binding mode. Before we do that, we want to get into the transmitter and turn on the binding mode on that. So let's just do that quickly. Okay, I'll do it from the internal. Yeah, I can do it with the internal with the telemetry on. So let's try with the internal first and see if that works. I will press the bind button here. So basically right now I'm not using that at all. I'm not going to use the module right now. I'm just going to start with the transmitter by itself, see how that does. So I figure out how to use the module properly. Okay, so now I'm just gonna press this button while I turn it on. There, we've got a bind, perfect. That's completely bound now. So now what we can do is we can take this out of that mode and we could escape from here, right? And we can unplug and replug this battery in. This in. Nice. So now basically if I turn this off, yep, we get the red blink, the red solid red light, basically to show you that it's not on. And then if we turn this on, it should rebind by itself. Yep, it rebound. It's green light now. Anyways, now that we have a bind, even though it's not with the R9M, let's unplug the drone and turn this off. Let us start putting stuff together. Nice. Yeah, so let me turn it on again. And I just want to see if it works in the goggles. Yep, it's all working properly.
Sweet.
All right, now that that's done and I've already connected the remote to it, it is time to get onto the laptop and make sure all the firmware is good, all the software, I mean. And yeah, that's pretty much it.
Let's open up Betaflight. And let's plug in. I was blocking the Betaflight stuff. Let's plug in the quad. And hopefully, if I've set up my drivers properly, it should all be fine. Yep. Nice. Yep, receiver is working perfect. Ah, but we have issue with the... Oh, we need to change this.
5 hours later.
All right, I think I figured it out. This is silly. I have to change the letters. We're gonna save this. Yay. We will now go ahead and flash the latest firmware. It's the F4, but what's the Omnibus F4? Yep. Okay, and we're going to choose the latest and greatest 3.5.4, and we will load it online. And then hopefully we can just flash it without any boot up. Flash the firmware. There we go. We got a DFU. And we are flashing. Excellent. Hopefully all the settings are saved. Otherwise I have to go in and retune and everything. Not retune. I have the pictures of how the tune was beforehand. So that is good. Hopefully I don't have to though, because that'd be pretty great. That'd be pretty great for sure. So I will now do the ESCs while I'm plugged in. I can turn off my remote now. I will calibrate the gimbals because the gimbals aren't calibrated properly. We will connect. We will read the setup. Okay, I'm not going to worry about that. 12, 12, 12, 12, 12. Not going to worry about that too much. I'm not going to fiddle with this stuff. I just want to flash all of their firmwares. And I will choose the latest version and flash. I'm just going to go over everything. I'll see if I forgot anything, but that's pretty much it. I was just changing the VTX to high power mode, and to do that, you just long press the button on the VTX for 10 seconds. That's pretty much it.
Well, that's it, everybody. Thank you very much for watching. I hope I was able to help you guys if you had any concerns, any, you know, thing you wanted to figure out. I try to include as much as I can in this video without making it too long. It probably is too long. I haven't edited it yet. We'll see. I forgot to put the props on, but I'm not going to put them on right now, but, like, to put them on, you know how to do it, you just literally